This is a true story about an 8-year-old boy who found himself in an orphanage just north of San Francisco in 1956. With his mother down on her luck and a father that had deserted them both when he was just 2 and a half, this little boy sat in an orphanage with other children who either had no parents or their parents had no money to care for them. Although the orphanage was clean, the children were fed, and their medical needs were always met, it could never replace family dinners, fighting with a brother or sister, or even being placed on restriction by your mom or dad for simply screwing up. The young boy would later say that living in the orphanage without the love of a family and having a place to call home made him feel empty inside, with the feeling of little to no hope. But Christmas Eve on 1956 changed everything for that 8-year-old boy. It all began in the large auditorium, where on a normal day the children would have their meals and try their best to play. But on this Christmas Eve night, the children were ordered to sit on the floor because the headmaster had something to tell them. At the end of what sounded like a Christmas speech, the children were told to go outside and get on buses that were waiting in front of the orphanage. They were asked to be quiet and behave on this ride to a destination as yet untold. Not knowing where they were headed, the orphans felt both anticipation and fear. Finally, the caravan of buses pulled into a place with large buildings. The buses came to a stop, and when the doors opened, in stepped a large man dressed in a uniform fit for a king. The man stood straight like a statue, and with a stern look on his face, he began to speak to the children. They were told in a firm voice to exit the bus and enter the adjacent building. Once inside the building, the children saw even more of the men, and now women, who were also dressed like kings. These larger-than-life figures guided the children to a place where they were told that a very special person, just beyond closed doors in the next room, was waiting for them. As the excitement and the anticipation of the children rose, the doors were opened by the uniformed statue figures. There in sight was Santa Claus and all his helpers, calling for the children to come and sit on Santa's lap. Santa handed out presents to each of the children. Even though the visit lasted for hours, it seemed like minutes to those youngsters who had nothing to call their own except for the presents they had just received. Afterwards, the uniformed figures ended up sitting on the floor, playing and laughing with the now smiling children. Many years later, the little boy would ask his mother, who were those men and women in uniform that took them to see Santa Claus so many years ago? She told her son they were United States Marines, and they did this every year as part of the Toys for Tots program all across the country. As the little boy, now a young man, entered high school, he knew he had a mission to pay back those men and women who made such a difference to him as a young child. So at the age of 17, July 1964, he joined the United States Marine Corps. And after 6 years of service, he received an honorable discharge. The little boy, now a grown and mature veteran, felt he had finally repaid the debt he owed. But following his discharge, he knew he had another debt to pay. The orphanage that took him in and cared for him so many years ago still weighed on his heart. But as fate would have it, in 1996, that same little boy, now a senior manager of a large corporation, was placed in charge of donating computers to needy causes. The first call he made was to that orphanage. After returning to the orphanage that had taken him in as a young boy, and supplying it with computers, he headed home. His ride home was filled with many emotions. He had finally completed both the missions that had always pressed upon his heart. This final mission that had begun as an 8-year-old boy had now come full circle. He was now in a position to help. The 8-year-old boy's name is Corporal Gary Miller. And today, when someone asks him what the Marine Corps means, he has only one answer: everything. I have a message from Corporal Gary Miller for all of you, and I'm going to quote his exact words. I am reminded each Christmas of these memories. I think about those less fortunate. I think about the children who are without the love of a family and live in poor communities and appear to have no future. As I envision those men and women dressed like kings so long ago, I know there is hope. There are miracles, and people are still given the gift of kindness. Ladies and gentlemen, Toys for Tots is not some worn-out cliche. It is, however, an opportunity for us to influence a child for the rest of his or her life. Please donate to this great cause.